Hey guys, Alex Kahn here, and we are finally going to take a look at the 1965 Shelby Cobra 427 that Elvis Presley drove in the 1966 Spin Out movie, which is a musical comedy with quite a bit of car action thrown in there, which I love. So before I go into the diecast and some of its inaccuracies with the movie version, I do want to talk about the box. So the box is made by Auto World, and so it was a die-cast, obviously. But this is a really cool box. One of my favorite die-cast boxes that I've ever seen, because it's got Elvis Presley and MGM stamped all over it. And it even has different frames from the movie in it. You can see some frames from when he's racing in the last scene. You can see the opening scene where he meets Fox Hughes' daughter, who's driving a Ferrari Cabriolet. Very similar to the one in Ferris Bueller, except that wasn't a cabriolet, it was a 1961 Spider, but very similar looking. And yeah, the box has all kinds of cool theming from the movie. You even have more shots with the McLaren Elva that Elvis Presley also drives in the middle of the movie, and more scenes from the racing at the end, and also more scenes from the beginning where Fox Hughes' daughter gets both of them kind of in a, almost in a car crash, where actually Elvis Presley does drive off on a bridge. But I'll talk more about that one later on. But it's a really cool box. Really, really like the box. But I want to talk about the die cast. So obviously this is 1/18 scale. Let me put Elvis by the driver's side here. So yeah, in the movie Spin Out, actually one of my favorite Elvis movie Presley. One of my favorite Elvis Presley movies. Like I said, there's a lot of singing in that movie, and they're actually pretty good songs. Probably not as good as the songs in Viva Las Vegas or Blue Hawaii, but there are some really solid songs in Spin Out as well. And as I said in my last review, I didn't really like the instrumental soundtrack too much, but I did like the movie overall. And if you don't know what the movie is, basically Elvis Presley is a singer slash race car driver. And pretty much everywhere he goes, girls just want to marry him. And that's a lot of the premise of the movie. The other big premise, as I said, he's a big race car driver. So one of the pretty daughter's fathers is a race car owner himself, and he's the one with the McLaren Elva, but they don't call it that. They call it the Fox 5. And I've shown that diecast in a different video, which I'll probably link in the video description for this one. Honestly, both cars are really awesome, but this car, the Shelby Cobra, gets a lot more screen time. At first, I thought it was very similar amount of time as the McLaren, but when I actually did the math, they do show this car a lot more. I think if I did the math correctly, this car actually gets about 18 minutes worth of screen time in the movie. So you first see this car in the opening scene when Fox Hughes' daughter pulls up next to Elvis Presley as he's driving. I don't know where he's driving, but she pulls up, she recognizes him, she starts racing him. And then eventually, they're both driving really recklessly, but she drives even more recklessly, and it leads to Elvis Presley getting driven off a bridge and into the river. And it's kind of funny the exchange that they have afterwards, because Foxy's daughter is just like, "Oh, you're all wet." This is after Elvis Presley drove off a bridge and could possibly be in a life-threatening situation, although in the movie he just stands up in the middle of the river like it's no big deal. And then yeah, you see the car later on too. It's in an alley scene. You also see bits of it while they're having a picnic. And then you see a lot of it too when Elvis Presley's trying to fix the car up. You see the car a lot when Elvis is driving his car on the track. And that's when his crew actually tells Fox Hughes to meet them out there with the Fox 5. So Elvis Presley drives this car, and then he also drives the Fox 5 for the only time in that movie. And then obviously in the big climactic race at the end, which takes about 9 minutes, you do see this car, and you also see the McLaren Elva. But the funny thing about this Elvis car is Elvis isn't driving this car in the final race, because what happens is Fox Hughes' assistant actually takes this car from Elvis before the race starts, so Elvis has to look around for an alternative car, which is some blue race car, which I know has a lot of history, but I don't really know the history behind the blue race car in that movie. And I looked it up. They don't have a diecast for that race car, as far as I know. But they have this as a diecast, and then another company made the McLaren Elva, the Fox V5, which I already reviewed. But yeah, let's talk about some of the inaccuracies with this diecast. And honestly, this is a pretty faithful recreation of the Shelby Cobra in Spinout. So in the back, I can only notice one mistake, but it's not really a mistake. I think this is more of a tribute. But in the big race at the end, there is no license plate here. So that's the only mistake I noticed in the back. And in the cockpit, there wasn't any really big mistakes there either. I noticed there was a bit more chrome trim on the steering wheel, from what I recall. But that's not really a big deal because I couldn't really notice it myself after watching the movie. But right here, see this this rear mirror? That should be closer to the center of the cockpit. But here, it's all the way towards the passenger side. On the front, these should be a bit more orange right here. And also, these, I don't know what this is, a fender, some kind of bumper. But whatever it is, it's not as chrome as it looks right there. But I think that's the only, those are the only real flaws, the only inaccuracies with this diecast. But yeah, the big I think the biggest flaw in my opinion was putting the rear mirror all the way out here. It has no purpose out there because the driver can't see anything. I guess he could, but in the movie, this mirror is towards the center here on the right side of the windshield on its immediate right. But yeah, aside from that, this car is very accurate to the movie. Now, remember when I said Elvis does drive into the river? In that scene where it's in the water, it's actually a different car. You can tell because of the grooves in the side of the car there. But yeah, this is a pretty good movie. Highly recommend it. And I did like the McLaren Elva a little bit more. It had some really cool smokestacks in the back where the engine was, or velocity stacks. But you know, everyone loves a Shelby Cobra, obviously. And I like these big aggressive tires on the back. And yeah, that is the number 11. All right, so what do you guys think of this diecast? Do you like this one better than the Fox Hoof or the Fox 5, which I'll link in the description, because I do kind of like the Fox 5 better. But this is also a sweet car too, obviously. All right, guys, post your thoughts. Let me know what you think.